There is a man who contributed immensely to the growth of education in Edo State, in Nigeria and the world at large. A selfless man of valor, grace and dignity, whose life and career elucidates the philosophy of eudaimonism because he's living a pleasant life, a Herculean feat for humanity, as aptly captured by the Greek eudaimonic philosopher Epicurus. It is impossible to live a pleasant life without living wisely and well and justly, and it is impossible to live wisely and well and justly without living a pleasant life. This enigma of an icon who has become an academic institution is indeed living wisely and well and justly. Who is this great legend?
There is one and only one such person alive today in the whole wide world. He is Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, the former Vice-Chancellor of the University of Benin.
Exactly!
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, is 70 years today, the 9th of August, 2020.
Professor O.G. Oshodi was born on the 9th of August 1950. Professor O.G. Oshodi, the great son of the Oloke Royal Dukedom, a devoted Christian, is a high jump gold medalist, a university don with great intellectual sagacity, an administrator par excellence, endowed with the tenacity and competence to achieve unprecedented goals and scarce financial and human resources. The great Asama of the universe and the honorary Romanian ambassador to Nigeria, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Usawari Gnadion JP, described Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP as a faithful son in whom he is well pleased.
When I heard Osayuki Oshodi was 70 years, I couldn't believe it. Yes. And I'm so happy. As I said, the father, the parents, and I will work out, but we grow up together. I know him not as a lecturer, as a student, and a pupil growing up crawling. Now, I've watched him. My happiness in his life, I'm grateful to my life that he did not let me down. Thirty people contested Agosto Shodi. God Almighty, not me, God, and his behavior and character, he was able to somersault all the contestants. Not that one I'm grateful for. When he was there, all of us that wish him well there to go to the position, he did not let us down. There have been a lot of vice chancellors in that relay. He was not the first, second, but when he came to excel. That is why manners is more important than anything. He was, if I can be shouting, because of his behavior, hard work, and dedication to his work, became a reference point. He's now a reference point in university. The other, my prayer to people, you cannot build an office without putting your foot down for some of time. He came, he planted tree, nursing tree, and the tree grew into Iroko tree. Even after he has left, he still be remembered to be the best, growing to God Almighty. And to that God that make me to support him at that time. Soft-spoken young man, but not like the father. The father was vibrant. So I'm grateful. The mother will bring him to church, Baptist church, ring group there. More important. So that to say that I know him to his bedroom every day of my life, I wish him a happy stay in life. As he remember to thank God every day, he will receive glory to God. And then also the wife and the mother-in-law stood by him. I am also congratulating the wife, good wife he has. Because when the home is not settled, no man can achieve. As I congratulate him, but Jody, I'm also congratulating his wife. I wish him a many, many more happy years in life.
The present Vice Chancellor of University of Benin, Benin City, Professor Lilian Imwetinya Salami Ni Emovo, described Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP as her mentor and father.
I am Professor Lilian Imwetinya Salami, and I always like to put Ni Emovo so that I am well placed where I belong. I am the current Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin, the 10th. Since the history of the university, almost 50 years ago. I am the second female vice chancellor and the first indigenous female vice chancellor of the University of Benin. Thank you for this opportunity, very rare opportunity to speak of a great man that I have known since I joined the University of Benin, transferred my services from the University of Maiduguri in 1994. He was indeed the very first person I interacted with when I came around, which was around when he was the Dean of Students. And I needed to have my children who transferred from the University of Benin, who was at that point my daughter especially, reading medicine. I needed hostel space. And so he was more or less the very first official individual that I met. And I explained to him, and he actually granted and gave the girl hostel space, hall one, precisely. And so over the period of years, we have grown closer. We have gotten to know that we share a lot in common. Incidentally, he's August 9th and I'm August 8th. And so even looking back to our birth dates, there is this strong similarity between both of us. And I think there is something about lions and lionesses, which of course is star, the bed star. We are very strong, very determined, dogged, if you may say. And so those qualities, some of those qualities that actually endowed me to Professor Oshodi. One thing I know is when he believes in a cause, he fights it with every altar of breath in him to make sure that that cause comes to fruitfulness. He's very dogged. He easily doesn't relent or give up a position that he truly believes in. He's a very strong-willed person. He, to me, is somebody who is very reliable. That is, of course, when he believes in something, you can count on him any day, any time. He is somebody who you can call upon any time, any day. I've had to call him very late hours and early hours of the morning, and he's there, and as bright as ever, and ready to move if he has to move. So he's somebody who can rely, you can rely. And so that those are some of the things that I have come to actually admire in him. And that has kept us going. So we've been very close. We've been good friends. He's been a father, a brother to me. And let me quickly also put in here that he's one of the very few who believed in me when I even applied for this job. He is also one of those that I had on one or two occasions when the heat was up that I had gone to say, look, I think it is time to get out of this race. And he kept saying, oh, do not. We are there for you. solidly behind, and true to his word, his truth. And so he's one of those that I actually owe my gratitude, you know, outside God, that believed that I am suitable for this job, and of God crowned our efforts. So I want to use this medium to say to him that he's somebody I would appreciate all days of my life, because he has actually seen me grow. Like you rightfully said, just before he became the VC, I was a director of GS. I became director, I continued under him. I became director of Patch Time, which again he graciously appointed me into. I became the chairman of Univen Integrated Enterprises. I left there, I came into council, two-time term in council, and I left and I became dean, all under Professor Oji Oshodi. And as soon as he left, I also left to ONDO, National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration. So you can see my history and my trend and my growth has been under his tutelage. So I owe a lot to this man, this wonderful, wonderful man. Very hardworking, and I think I've always said to anyone, when you're working, even when you don't see the physical being, human beings appreciating you, I believe that God Almighty is always watching everyone. And he's the one who actually appoints, who actually elevates. So I have come to look at his strength, his belief, and above all, I think that you must be consistent. Consistency for me is something that I cannot compromise. I want to wake up when I call something white, and when I go to bed it's still white. It doesn't change over time. It remains consistent. And so for me, that is part of what life is all about. Let people be able to predict who you are and not sway at any wind or any direction. And so that to me is a strength. Hard work, consistency, and be who you are, irrespective of what the situation is. Every day I look at him and I thank God for his life. And I know my greatest wish for him is that all he has toiled for, all he has worked for, that God add life to his years and years to his life, so that he would live to reap the fruits of the land into ripe age. No matter what the health challenges are, it is God who heals. And I believe that he will still heal him to the admiration of everyone. So I wish him well. I wish him long life. I wish him good health. I wish him good vigor. And I, above all, I ask that Almighty God give him the strength to continue to pilot affairs, even at his own, you know, position as an elder statesman, as we call him. Thank you very much.
My good chief, Nosagare Idugo Isipure, justice of peace, and peace ambassador of the United Nations. Professor Dr. Former Vice Chancellor of the United Nations is a contemporary. And we are also contrary in terms of age.
Okay.
We were born in the same year, 1950. And his family house is just opposite my house. That is the Oshodi family house. And his father is just about 400 meters away from here. The maternal family, maternal and mother's family, just at the back of our premises. So we grew up together. We knew each other for a very, very long time, and we have been very, very good friends and contemporaries. So I believe that this is, I'm going to celebrate, because I am going to see your fellow person to whom we grew up and share the same aspiration. And to whom we have shared some blessings, marvelous, we must share the glory of the celebration of the birthday. And I want to wish you a very happy, prosperous celebration and more years. It should be granted to whom by the Almighty God and to me too, so that we can enjoy the bounty of what life gives to every man. He's in Germany they call it a chick of the old block. Chick of the old block, that to say, is like his father and mother. Mother wanted Carolina educationist in Midwest, Nigeria Midwest and big state now. For a person of such nature and to also be able to enjoy education in spite of the privilege he had all along. His mother was a very wealthy woman. The father was also a very, very wealthy timber man, well known beneath. His ancestors were also noble people, Oshodi family, known just opposite my dear woman. So, those days, you know, to come from a profound family, usually breeds spoiled children. You don't have to go to school, you don't have to do it. That is, the father was able to dedicate himself to the person. Traveled to the US, went to Western Boys High School, after which he left for the US, graduated, and then returned to Lillibear to lecture, and then ultimately became the Vice Chancellor. That is the ultimate university system. That is a profound achievement. And anybody that hears that ought to be able to emulate and also to let our children know that it's good to be rich, but there are greater things than wealth. Good men. Maybe the good men is better than riches and gold. Everybody is from a rich family. His father is rich. His mother is also rich and well educated. His mother is one of the most educated adult person I know in this country. So it is him that we praise for being able to ignore the existing facility he met, you know, to get the common word. One way or the other, like do it, no chicken, do the chicken, provide it to you, provide it to yourself, do for me. Well, do whatever. Then went straight to school to the US, graduated, came back. On the day he came back from the US, you know, after I graduated, it was to celebration. This guy came back, his father said, okay, so come out. And then share the glory. Educational achievement. Entered the event as a lecturer. Ultimately, became invited.
The present Pro Chancellor of Edo University, Iyamo, Emeritus Professor T.O.K. Audu, described Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodin JP as a selfless and dependable friend and brother.
I am a Professor T.O.K. Audu, Professor Emeritus, Professor of Chemical Engineering. Right now, I'm the Pro Chancellor and Chairman Governing Council, Edo University, Iyamo. So, I have known Professor Oshodi for a very long time. We are close friends. In fact, we happen to belong to a club called the Happiness Club in the University of Benin. And his title in Happiness Club is Okpia of Sokoto, while I'm the Duke of Happiness. That's my own title. We have been close associates in the sense that we've served on several committees together, and One thing that is clear about Professor Oshodi is that he's a no-nonsense person. It's very straightforward. He's a quintessential man. A man who believes that what is due to somebody, that person should be given. And he proved it in my own case and in many other cases. For example, in my case, I believe my letter of appointment as PTDF, that is Petroleum Technology Development Fund chair, professorial chair in renewable energy. He signed that letter, and I believe that letter was the first letter he signed on assumption of office in 2009, because the person who was on seat then, for reasons best known to him, didn't want to sign that letter. He signed that letter and then he made me a PTDF professor, because I had undergone interview in October of that year. He is someone who believes that if there is conflict, that conflict should be resolved amicably. If there are problems with students, he will insist that due process is taken. In the development of the university, he did a lot. During his tenure as Vice Chancellor, he promoted a lot of new programs that were approved by the National Universities Commission. And you know, in the university system, there is what is called program accreditation, and there's something called university accreditation. The program accreditation is for various faculties and departments to present their programs to NUC for consideration for accreditation. During his time, most of the programs were accredited. And as far as university accreditation was concerned, because it was coming up for the first time during his tenure, he appointed me chairman of the committee for the university accreditation, which meant that the committee that had the two vice chancellors and the registrar as members had to go around the whole university, Ubowo campus, Ekenwa campus, to look at the structures, the facilities that were available, to enable him come up with ways of renewing and redeveloping what we have on campus. During his tenure, new hostels came up, new departments, departmental buildings, new faculty buildings. And I'm sure as we were driving in, especially for the cameramen who might not be conversant with this campus, you will see one building just before the faculty, that what they call faculty of social sciences. That building was constructed during his time. And you were to turn right to go towards education, the education building was built during his time. The other building to the right of education, which is now housed by, I think it's quantity surveying.
Yeah, quantity surveying.
It was also built during his time. And he was very good. He employed a lot of people. How was he able to do this? You will ask, where did he get the money to ensure that those people who were employed were paid? He discovered that something had gone wrong somewhere in the bursary. He was able to get the accounts, the numerous accounts that were opened in different banks in Nigeria and even abroad. And he was able to recover those funds. So no wonder at some point in time, we suddenly found that he became ill. You see, because how many people want changes? Not many people like changes, you know. And
when you now want to make changes because of what you have discovered, people will go after you. But I thank God that in his infinite mercies, Oshodi is still alive today. And that he'll be able to celebrate his birthday on Sunday. 70th birthday on Sunday, the 9th of August. And I am sure you will all join me in wishing him a very prosperous, healthy birthday celebration, and that God will allow him to live many more years. Because as somebody like Oshodi, he is not finished yet. He still has a lot to offer society. In fact, you need to be in an inaugural lecture when Oshodi's name is mentioned. You will see the ovation that follows it. So he's a great statesman, and I wish him the very best. A professor that is quintessential. He's a professor who does not like people to be oppressed. He doesn't like oppression. He doesn't like it. You know, I don't want to be giving example myself all the time, you know, but I'm afraid I have to say this particular one. I remembered when suddenly my emolument from the PTDF chair was stopped without any reason. And when I went in there to his office to tell him that I observed that I had not been paid for about 2 months or so. And he now wanted to know what was wrong. Luckily, the registrar just walked in. And she said, okay, she will look into it. But I smelled a rat. Eventually, it was Oshodi. Followed me. He just held my hand and we walked to the registrar's office. He said they should go and bring my file. And it was late Abak, that is now late.
Yeah.
Yes. Was the one who went to bring the file. And he saw it. He said, there's nothing wrong here. What's the problem? Go and pay him. That was it. During students, when students have complaints and they want to riot, he addresses them. Tells them, look, you can riot. Don't destroy anything. Don't use your opportunity to go and lock the gates. You don't lock gates when you riot. When you have satisfied yourselves, you sit down, chat over the matter, and discuss it. And his method for discipline was very clear. He never at any time jumped the disciplinary procedure, you know, where you have to go through due process. An ad hoc committee has to be set up. They will be given terms of reference. Those who have the problem are invited. After that, it will go, the report will be sent. And that report can be a report that goes to Senate. It can be a report that goes directly to the Vice Chancellor, depending on the type of problem. Okay? And if it's the one that goes to Senate, after Senate, if Senate so decides, it will go to Council Disciplinary Committee. And it's only after Council Disciplinary Committee has taken a decision that the Vice Chancellor can now act. And he was extraordinary in the way he manage the affairs of University of Benin. The advice I have for the youths is that they should be straightforward. Youths should, especially the academics and the non-teaching staff, they should be focused. Do their work. Don't compromise yourselves. When an environment where we are standing in loco parentis, you know, we are representing the parents of the students, most of whom were leaving home for the first time, and our relation to them can determine a lot. We should be fair, and I believe that any hardworking staff will get his or her promotion when it is due. I want to use this opportunity to wish my friend Professor Ojo Oshodi a very happy birthday. I wish him many happy returns. I pray for long life, good health, prosperity, good neighborliness, and to have his open mind. He should not change his ways, because I know that God that has kept him till now will continue to be with him, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The present Vice Chancellor of Igbinedion University Okada, the first private university in Nigeria, Professor Lawrence Ikechukwu Ezomoye, also described Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodin JP as his mentor and father.
My name is Professor Lawrence Ikechukwu Ezomoye. I'm a professor of ecotoxicology and environmental forensics. I'm currently the Vice Chancellor of Igbinedion University of Okada. Professor Oji Oshodi, from my own perspective, is a blessed and favored destiny child. Professor Oshodi is an enigma of some sort, iconic in his achievements, and legendary in perspective, in perspectives and his narratives of life. It's very legendary. And that is why people often describe him as a living legend. His career profile of Professor Oji Oshodi is cosmopolitan, and it drives and is always spiced with bespoke achievement. So peculiarity of Professor Oshodi is what makes the uniqueness of Oshodi. The milestones of Oshodi captures generational significance, and that is why in most cases it's described as the transformational leader of our time. That's Professor Oshodi. He's a thoroughbred and quintessential academic. We all know that. And he's also an astute and purposeful administrator. His tenure at the University of Benin as Vice Chancellor, it's remarkable, astounding. If you consider the capacity building profile of Oshodi, if you consider the infrastructural profile of Oshodi, if you consider the academic development and structure of Oshodi as Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin, they are all breathtaking. And that again spells out the uniqueness of Oshodi. If I must say this, and let me say it very clearly, that Professor Oshodi exhibits the fundamental of uncommon generosity and a people's leader. He's a living legend. I speak with resolute conviction of a charismatic team leader who is my revered mentor and an added bridge builder for us. If you consider the posture of Professor Oshodi in terms of administration, this is one man who decided to be very liberal with administrative instruments so that others can grow. I learned the precepts of administration from Professor Oshodi, having worked with him in different capacities, culminating as being a deputy vice chancellor in administration. He provided me a platform that exposed me to the all administrative strategies that are required for both human and infrastructural growth. And today I bring them to bear in my current position as Vice Chancellor of the University. Professor Oshodi at 70 is a testament and a testimony. I never described him as a favored one and a blessed child. That is so, and really so, Professor Oshodi. The Lord God Himself had decided to select him from the generation to make him one of his own for specific purpose. The Lord God chose Professor Oshodi, decided to give him life, decided to supply him with all essential ingredients to be a leader, to be an achiever. And today, we celebrate him at 70. At 70, he's still vibrating with life, with candor, and again, with uncommon strength. That exemplifies one who God has blessed, and you cannot take it away from him. So, I join the teaming fans, mentees, friends, associates, and family members of Professor Oshodi to thank God for his life. The likes of Oshodi are always described as one in a generation. You can also say they are one in a million. It's the same thing, because you don't find them so often. But when you find them, you cherish them. One thing the youths of today must learn from Professor Oshodi is humility. Humility in position and humility in service. The other thing they must learn from Professor Oshodi is also his trust in God for perfection. Oshodi is very generous and humane. He's a bridge builder. Oshodi is a team player and tries to carry everybody along. That is why today both the big, the small, the rich, the poor are his friends. I talked about Oshodi being cosmopolitan in training. That has also influenced his lifestyle, highly tribalized. These are the qualities that I would like you to relate from Professor Oshodi. Professor Oshodi is very knowledgeable, highly competent. And competence and knowledge provide innovation. And the youths of today require to put on their thinking caps, because creativity and innovation through skill acquisition is what rules today. And this is exactly the attributes Professor Oshodi has exhibited over time. He's a very homely person, highly jovial, but though shy at times. They have been described in different parlance, in different ways, but I sum it up to say that he's a good gentleman and a blessed one. The fact that I came all the way to grant this interview expresses the fact that my stomach is currently filled with butterflies for the life of the profession. At 70, I pray that the Almighty God continue to sustain good life, good health, sound mind and body, prolonging his days, making them again more eventful than the last 70 years. And to God be the glory.
This father of several vice chancellors and heads of tertiary institutions within and outside the Old Bendel State, Edo and Delta States, Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP, was described as a detribalized Nigerian, a hard worker, an astute administrator, a mentor, a great achiever, a trailblazer, and a man with an excellent spirit.
My name is Abiodun Falodo. Professor of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, University of Benin, one time the people at Chancellor Academy, the same preacher, University of Benin. And by the grace of God now, the rector of Edo State Polytechnic, Usain. Professor Oji Oshodi, JP, first I would say he's a living legend. He's my mentor. He's a leader. And he's also my father. You recall that Professor Oji Oshodi was one time the Vice Chancellor of our great university, University of Benin. And during that time, Professor Oji Oshodi brilliantly executed his administrative and academic work. As a matter of fact, he's an administrator by excellence. This is a man that is fully interested in the progress of individuals. I would say that also Oji Oshodi is an academic deity. If you like, he's an academic idol. I'll say this because when he was Vice Chancellor of our great university, the University of Benin was completely transformed to be among the top 5 universities in Africa. If you go to history, remember that the University of Benin was number 1 in webometric ranking. And not only that, Professor Oji Oshodi, as Vice Chancellor of our great university, also transformed the academic and more importantly, the geographical landscape of our great institution. Many of the physical structures you see in this great university is a product of his administrative acumen. Professor Oji Oshodi, like I said, is a living legend. You remember, during his time also, he put smiles on the faces of many people, thousands of people. He employed individuals, he employed qualified persons into a great institution, following due process and due diligence. And that alone, of course you agree with me. Today, Professor Oji Oshodi is celebrated worldwide. He's not just a national icon, he's an international icon. There's nowhere you mention Professor Oji Oshodi that people will not look back and say, yes, that man has contributed greatly to the success story of our great university. It's also a record because the man we are talking about, Professor Oji Oshodi, JP, is the first and the only person inducted into the University of Benin Hall of Fame because of his monumental achievements and contribution to the great University of Benin. And so today we celebrate the man, Professor Oji Oshodi, who is interested in building institutions, and systematically he has a way of doing that. He builds the individual has done build the institution. I am a product of his, I'm a living legacy of Professor Oji Oshodi. So Professor Oji Oshodi, JP, has affected lives positively. I can tell you, in our great institution, University of Benin, in Edo State, in Nigeria, general, the man has touched virtually every sector. At a time, if you remember, he also made a strong impact in Nuga Games. Can we see such leadership? Such leadership is rare. In fact, indeed, it's a trailblazer. When I say it's an idol, I know exactly what I'm saying. As a matter of fact, for some of us, the Professor O.G. Oshodi School of Leadership, which will be inaugurated very soon, will be a platform for us to sell its ideas, what it stands for. Because the man is a rare gem. It transcends beyond the physical. I tell you that. Let me tell you, administratively, for example, I've benefited greatly from him. Professor Oshodi believes that workers should be promoted at the appropriate time. And so when he was Vice Chancellor of the Great University of Benin, promotion was carried out at the right time. So a lot of persons, a lot of academic and non-teachers have benefited from that. In those days, it can take many years for you to move from one step to the other, from one position to the other, because of the evil deeds of men. But he came, he saw, he conquered. And today, the entire world is celebrating this man. I will also let you know that, I'm just giving it out, I'm writing a book on Professor O.G. Oshodi. Because when you see him, you see academic excellence. When you see him, you see a man that is a philanthropist, always willing to give. He's always willing to be instrumental to your success story without asking for anything. As for such individuals, like I said before, they are rare. And so, for us, who are his living legacy, we will continue, by the grace of God, to work based on his principles and improve on it. I can tell you, Edo State Polytechnic today, some of the ideas, principles being executed today, I learned it from this great man, Professor O.G. Oshodi. I remembered some years back, Professor O.G. Oshodi personally affected my life, possibly. God used him to take me from grass to grace. It cannot be forgotten. He's a man that is ready at any point in time to see that University of Benin, this great citadel of learning, continue to soar higher. And that is why his commitment and passion for this great institution is second to none. I can tell you this. For every situation, for every issue, Professor Joshua will always be seeking for the best. He is an accomplished educationist, an accomplished Edoma. He has affected the lives of Edo people, not just in this academic ecosystem, but generally. When you go to some countries in the world today, in Asia, America, Europe, Professor Ojo Shodi has your name. Today is celebrating, he's celebrating his birthday, 70th birthday. My prayer for him that God Almighty will grant him long life. He is aging gracefully. He will still be there for us because he's not tired. He's still very much energetic. He has the zeal, the energy. And so with us, as his children, we'll continue to be with him and surround him. My prayer for his entire family is that he will continue to be number one. He will continue to soar high. He will not fall, he will not faint, he will not fail. And that is a man that I can say today, he is my father. Professor Ojo Shodi, indeed, he is extraordinary. Is beyond the physical. It's a man that has affected generations. May God continue to bless him, grant him more strength and wisdom.
I'm Professor Mrs. Stella Chinyiche Emeke, a professor of computer science, the first female professor of computer science at University of Benin. And currently I'm the rector of Delta State Polytechnic Ogbuashukwu, Delta State, Nigeria. There are many ways to describe Professor Ojo Shodi. He's a seasoned administrator, he's a successful academician, a manager of men and resources, he's a renowned scholar, he's a true and inspirational leader who carries a touch of wisdom and enlightens the people around him. He is a great achiever and a noble personality, and also he's a dedicated and committed researcher. After 10 years of his developmental stride in the University of Benin, as Vice Chancellor, his achievements still speak loud. Professor Ojo Shodi is one man which I am honored to describe as a dogged achiever with uncommon leadership style. On assumption of office as Vice Chancellor, Professor Ojo Shodi assembled the best among the best, irrespective of tribe, religious, and professional differences. His vision was to advance the frontiers of research and teaching, and to also promote infrastructural and human capacity development in the University of Benin. I'm indeed honored to be in his noble team as the Director of Information, Communication and Technology and CRPU Department for 4 years. Working with Professor Ojo Shodi in his quest to position University of Benin on the map of the 10 best universities in Africa was both tasking, and it was an opportunity to learn new skills and experiences. It will interest us to know that under his leadership, University of Benin came out first twice in the web ranking of high institutions in Nigeria. I would say that I learned a lot working under his leadership as Vice Chancellor, and these new skills, experiences and exposure have in no small way shaped my philosophies in life, both as an administrator, a researcher and a teacher. I would like to refer to the quote of Cesar Chavez that there is no substitute for hard work. I would like to admonish our young people in service that hard work pays. With the grace of God Almighty and with dedication to whatever is committed to our hands, we will achieve success. The world has been blessed by such an amazing man for a whole 70 years. Prof, as you celebrate your 70th birthday, I and my family want to wish you many more years ahead, good health of body and mind, strength and wisdom to continue the noble works you are known to do for humanity. Sir, I'm wishing you many more fruitful years. Aid gracefully to the glory of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
This bridge builder and lover of justice, Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP, was also described by one of his close allies, Professor Felix Ebodage Okeme, a professor for 31 years standing, a one-time deputy vice chancellor and present dean of School of Postgraduate Studies, University of Benin, Benin City, as a true friend, a lover of his people and disciplinarian.
My name is Felix Ebodage Okeme. I'm presently the Dean of Postgraduate Studies at this university. I have been Dean of Physical Sciences, Pioneer Dean of Physical Sciences. I've been head of this department, and I have served as Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic several years ago. I have known Professor Oshodi since the 80s. When he assumed duty here at the University of Benin from the USA. I, about the same time, have resumed duty here from the United Kingdom. My first encounter was why he was coordinating the part-time programs, BA part-time programs of the Faculty of Education. I took a ward to that place, and that was my first encounter with him. Saw this handsome, tall, lanky, athletic built man standing up and attending to several large number of students, listening to them, giving them instruction, taking documents for them, noting their particulars while standing up, hours on end. That is a very unique characteristic for somebody who can be engaged in many physical things and yet maintain mental alertness, not to make mistakes. I find that very unique to Professor Oji Oshodi. When I later started calling him Strong Man, that is where the Strong Man came from. Not Hard Man, Strong Man. And since then we have become friends. We worked together when he was Dean of Students. We worked together in an administration. And like I said, somewhere else, the University of Benin never had a Dean of Students like Professor Oshodi. And we may never have another Dean of Students like Professor Oshodi. Because of the way he asserted himself on the job, ensured that student facilities that were derelict, both in the Kewa and Ogbogbo campuses, were renovated, maintained, introduced new structures to make sure the life of students on campus or on the campuses were good. He did very well. I'm sure this attribute served him well when he eventually became the Vice Chancellor of this university. You want me to go on? Okay. Like I also said elsewhere, Professor Oshodi also served as director of sports and dean of education. And like I said elsewhere, it appears that Oshodi was ordained, anointed to perform. performed his service in the University of Benin because it's apparent that he served better than his predecessors in those offices and created a peace for his successors to meet. So that is the sort of man that Oshodi is. Professor Oshodi is easy to get along with if you know him. If you don't know him, you may have other feelings. But like I also said elsewhere, he's a man of many parts. And for those who don't know him, you need to get close enough to him to see his humaneness and capacity for compassion and helping others. Does that mean that Professor Oshodi is a saint? Nobody is a saint. He doesn't suffer detractors, backstabbers, and traitors lightly, but can easily forget if you come to him and ask for forgiveness. That's what I mean. Who is a saint? So that is my own perspective of Oshodi. He has done very well. Like I said, he's a peace setter in every aspect of university life that he has had the opportunity to serve. The Professor Oshodi I know was not always loved by his people, but he served his people always with love and commitment. So the young people should know the sky is the limit. If you work hard, if you are committed, I'm not from his ethnic group. I'm the one talking about him like this because of the opportunity. I had to be very close from him. You don't judge somebody from the outside. He's a man of many parts. He's intelligent. He's dedicated. He's compassionate. He's loving. He's likable. He's sociable. And he's a bridge builder. That is what most of you young people should follow. If you're a bridge builder, it means that you can interact with not only for people, it's not a club. You have to survive in a community. The community embraces people from different perspectives, people that may not behave like you do, may not like the things you look. So when you say, so he's a community leader, that is what it means. He builds and leads community, not a club. That people only think like him. That would not occur where he would have earned all these accolades if he was a club member, not a community member. It seems so soon that Professor Oshodi should be the strong man.
Yeah.
Turn 70. I wish you the best always, best wishes for you always. You are not weak. You're taking a back seat like generals do, the right war from the back. So I hope that you will continue to provide the leadership that you have always done to the university from the back seat. You are now a full 5-star general. I wish you the best. Good health.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP is not just a community leader, as aptly stated by Professor Okeme, but a comrade indeed, as excitedly expressed by the union leaders of University of Benin, where he worked for about 4 decades.
My name is Professor Julius C. Asele, the immediate past chairman of Academic Staff Union of Universities, Uniben branch. Let me posit here that I'm highly honored to be given an opportunity to talk about an enigma of an icon. That is Professor Oshodi, that superintended over this university at various times, because I know he was also dean of students. He was dean of education, and at the penultimate, he became the vice chancellor of this university. But let me quickly say that Professor Oshodi cannot be in an office and there's no movement. While he was here as the vice chancellor, we saw a lot of things happen, particularly the structural changes that took place in this university.
When I talk about structural changes, you can have what we call the physical change, and you can have otherwise changes. Under the physical changes, buildings germinated here as against what we used to know. This university remained or subsisted as it was at the creation at about the 70s until Professor Oshodi came. And you saw buildings springing up left, right, and center. That is why I say it's unlikely you will find him anywhere without things happening. But then let me talk about the other changes, for instance, human capital development. Many of our wives, even before then, before he ascended, who were hitherto bothering us in our homes because there were no jobs, got jobs. Yours sincerely is a beneficiary. So, and then, for you to climb up, to know, to prove me whether I'm right or wrong, is let Professor Oshodi walk into any gathering of the University of Benin. The thunderous ovation that we visit his entrance is enough testimony for anybody. Because even some friends who had come and didn't know him before, we asked questions, who is he? Because of the thunderous ovation. Let me tell you, that was why I said an enigma of an icon. That is whom he is. Academically, people grew here. People who were stagnated by some primordial settings and otherwise had opportunity to breathe, because it's an era of we can't breathe. So people breathed while he succeeded and superintended over this university. Left, right, and center, people were employed. Monies that were that had their ways into some other things in the past privately became, you know, the rescue of a lot of downtrodden in the society. I can go on and on and on and on. Enough giving, if not for the airtime that may be apportioned to me now, but a lot of things you can say about that man. But it's just for me to continue to wish him, like many of us had prayed, when some illnesses came towards the twilight of his administration, that never he has to, you know, benefit the rewards of his office. And I'm sure the prayer of the saints had continued to keep him and will continue to keep him. I'm wishing him 70 years. God has approved more, that is it. Because he told Jehoshaphat, he said, the battle is not of him. So the battle is not of him, and so I know that he will be alive. Some of us are from a distance. He didn't know greatly what was on our minds about his person. But he's a very likable person, somebody you will love. Any man who is interested in other people's progress cannot, a light that is lighted and put on a mountain cannot be hit. That is Professor Oshodi. Happy 70 cheers on his 70th birthday.
Yeah, it's a privilege to be part of this interview. My name is Comrade Broderick Osewa, the chairman of JAC, the Joint Action Committee of all the non-teaching unions in the University of Benin, and the past president of the Senior Staff Club of the University of Benin. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi is the penultimate Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin, and an astute leader, strict yet very compassionate. He is a mentor and a caregiver, He's coming into the viceship of the University of Benin, brought a lot of changes. In his time, he took the university to the epitome of excellence. Some of us, as mentors, brought us up and told us that the only way to the top is hard work. And today, a lot of us at different positions, you know, are blessed by his mentorship. And we thank God for his life. As a caregiver, I will tell you that my union, all the non-teaching unions of the University of Benin, benefited so much from him. He went outside the boundaries of the University of Benin and went to homes where their youths were in the streets, and gave them employment. And I know today, a lot of them are praying for him, because they will never forget who God used to get them a job. We know the situation in this country today, and nobody has ever been able to replicate what Professor O.G. Oshodi did at that time. Coming to my union, coming to the university community, we are back to where we were before Oshodi took us to a higher level, where salaries will come the second month, maybe 2 weeks into the second month before we will receive salaries. But when Oshodi took over as Vice Chancellor, we started having what we call Oshodi alert. By 25th, by 26th, our salaries will drop. That's the mark of a man and a mark of an astute leader. I remember an occasion where the federal government paid us allowances, and allowances. But some of us within the system were trying to delay the payments. Oshodi came as early as 8 o'clock in the morning and stood in the office and said, these people must get their salaries today. That is the man Oshodi is. And some of us, we have gained from him so much, to the extent that wherever we are today, we use his standard as a measure to do whatever we are doing. Well, for me, I want to thank God for his life. We wish him well. In this new phase of his life, we wish him good health. And for him and his family, we are praying God to let his face shine upon them and to protect them from all evils. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, on behalf of JAC, the Joint Action Committee of all the non-teaching unions of the University of Benin, we want to wish you the best in life. We want to wish you long life and prosperity. Isoleto, E Africa.
One may be wondering why union leaders of the University of Benin in the present-day Nigeria adores Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP. This is because Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP himself is a true and consistent comrade who pays serious attention to the welfare of lives. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, never withholds from you the good he can give today, not even to a later day. This benevolent professor of health education is also a man of truth and justice, as expressed by a one-time member of University of Benin Governing Council, a one-time Dean of Student and Dean of School of Postgraduate Studies of the University of Benin, Benin City, Professor Victor Omozuwa.
I am Professor Victor Edosa Omozuwa. But as most of you would have known, I was the Dean of Students in 2012 to 2014. and then the overseer of Ekewan campus for the same period. From 2015 to 2018, I was the dean of postgraduate school. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Linguistics, but I specialize in experimental phonetics. Well, Professor Oji Oshodi is a great man. He's, one would say, an enigma as far as the University of Benin is concerned. Because during his period here as Vice Chancellor, you know, we saw a huge developmental stride, right? Uh-huh. So he's a good man, he's a man of peace, and well, you know, you can use a whole lot of positive attributes to him. You know, he's a kind-hearted person. Well, against the background of how he came to, because, you know, you have to look at it from that point of view, because, you know, for 40 years after the inception of the University of Benin, you know, we didn't have a Benin person as the Vice Chancellor. And during those 40 years, you know, most of us who came in at that time experienced a whole lot of discrimination of all types. And, well, you know, there appeared to be a gang up between the other tribes and the Benins. Against the Benins. So, anytime a Benin man comes out for any elective position, the other people would just gang up against him. It was like that for those good years, 40 years, right? You know, I may not have time to expatiate on, you know, these things now, but they are real. Okay, now, 40, you know, at 40, that is when the university was 40 years, you know, the Benin people as a tribe, right? You know, said, no, this is very, very unusual. Not only do we have a lot of, you know, capable hands to be Vice Chancellor, but to say that we are, you know, this place, the university is cited here, it became a serious issue. We say, how come that our sons and daughters are, you know, deliberately, excluded from being the Vice Chancellor? So the, you know, the Benin people came together and said, well, you know, this time we have to, you know, make sure that one of our own becomes the Vice Chancellor. So it was a very serious battle, so to speak. So, well, you know, as the Almighty God will have it, you know, Professor Oshodi emerged as the first Benin Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin, 40 years after inception. So it was a landmark, right? Landmark in the sense that, you know, we expected that some of all those suffering, some of all those, you know, discriminations we were going through, you know, was going to be corrected, because a Benin man is known for justice. You know, yes, you know, because we always do the right thing. And I can tell you that Professor Oshodi didn't do otherwise. Because, one, before he came to this place as the Vice Chancellor, there were many, you know, promotions, step down, promotions they sat on. For years, you know, I had a personal experience. For no reason, not that I didn't, you know, work hard, not that I didn't have the required publications and the rest of them. My promotions from you know, SL to Associate Professor was just sat on, Professor Kubenje, right? During the period he was there as acting Vice Chancellor, you know, after suffering for about 6 years, nothing was said about my promotion. I had to, you know, appeal to the then committee they set up, right? You know, federal government, you know, what is that committee? What is it? Yes, they came, you know, at that time. Yeah, so, you know, I presented my case, and then they, you know, asked Kumbenje to handle the issue. Well, you know, within 3 months, my promotion was announced as, you know, associate professor. So that was what it was at that time. And then, you know, the beginning of a revolution, so to speak. So after that, Professor Oshodi came in and upheld that position of not, you know, punishing people unduly for before they are promoted. So since that time, he makes sure that when any person is due for promotion, he gets it. And then there is this process of evaluation, external assessors. So he makes sure that within 90 days, you know, the assessor must, you know, submit his report on any person. So that changed the whole thing. So, and that benefited everybody, whether you were a Benue or not Benin, everybody benefited. That was a huge, you know, revolution in this place. And since that time, till I'm talking, you know, up to this time I'm talking, there has not been any going back. In the sense that people are promoted, you know, as at when due. Okay? So to me, you know, if it didn't uphold that principle of let this person, you know, let all assessment come in within 90 days, would have been, you know, well, where before he came in, when for 6 years, some for, you know, more than that, you know, they don't have their promotion for no just cause, right? Selected people, they do, you know, that too. Okay, but now you don't hear of that in University of Benin. Okay, so that is one. Then two, the appointments he made. You see, there was this, not to, you know, many outsiders, that at the end of the year, money made for, you know, such employment, they call it establishment, whether they were sending it back, very rarely, you know, that they sent the money back to Abuja, but most often, you know, it went into private hands. But Oshodi came in and said no, he was not going to be party to that sharing of such money. Instead, he will use it to employ more people, and many people benefited from that. There is virtually no family in Benin City that didn't benefit from that. And so, you know, it was the same for other tribes. So, you know, we didn't limit it just to only the Benin people. He was very, you know, kind-hearted and broad-minded. So, everybody, every tribe benefited. And that was, you know, the way he handled the university at that time, you know, everybody with equal, you know, treatment, no discrimination, you know, whatsoever. And so, you know, to me, that was enough to term him an enigma. And because since that time too, you have physical development of the university, physical development of all anything you can, you know, I mean, buildings. You know, the faculties were developed. You know, there was human development. You know, people were getting their normal, I mean, what's it called?
Promotion.
Promotions, and then, you know, study leaves and the rest of them. Even the non-academics were now also, you know, benefiting from, you know, leaves and all that. So, you know, he did a great job in this university.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP is a true academics and mentor par excellence, as attested to by the present Deputy Vice Chancellor in charge of academics in the University of Benin, Professor D. Izeko.
I am Professor David Nosahai Izeko, the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, University of Benin. I was appointed here in University of Benin, my first appointment in University of Benin after being appointed a lecturer. I was given the position of examination officer way back in my department. From that place, I was appointed assistant dean, School of Postgraduate Studies, where I served for 5 years. And that automatically made me the longest serving assistant dean of School of Postgraduate Studies. And management was so impressed with my service delivery. While still serving as assistant dean, I was appointed head of department, and I ran the affair of my department for 2 years. On completion of my assignment as head of department, I was immediately appointed as the Director of General Studies, a position I held until I was appointed recently as the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academy here in the University of Benin. I have had a very good and robust interaction with Professor Oji Oshodi in the course of my work here in the University of Benin. He is a man I would describe as an institution. Professor Oji Oshodi has contributed so much to the growth and development of the nation's ivory tower, not just in the University of Benin, but the entire university and educational system in Nigeria. He's a man who is very dependable. He's very reliable. He's a confidant. Professor Oji Oshodi is a great man. He's a great teacher. Teacher par excellence. He's a man that can be trusted, and he's a man who will stand and defend your cause at any time, not minding whether you are among the high, the lowly, or the poor. So long as you have a just cause, Professor Oji Oshodi will stand by you. He's a defender of justice. Above all, he's a gentleman and he's a good man. In the course of my interaction with Professor Oji Oshodi, I have learned a lot from him. As I mentioned a while ago, Professor Oji Oshodi is a very trusted and a dependable man. He is very patient and a purpose-driven man, very focused, and who believes in his ability to attain those objectives, those feats that people consider impossible. So I want the young ones, the academics, to imbibe that spirit, the spirit of teamwork, the spirit of togetherness, the spirit of not saying this thing is not is impossible, it cannot be done. Professor Oshodi doesn't have anything like impossibility in his dictionary. He believes everything is possible when we work together as a team. And our young academics should imbibe this spirit, spirit of patience, spirit of tolerance. These are some of the things I have learned from Professor Oji Oshodi. For a man who has worked and has attained the age of 70, my prayer and wish for him is that God should continue to bless him. God should continue to keep him and grant him good health, so that he can enjoy the reward of his labor. He has worked hard, and this is a time for him to sit back, relax, and begin to enjoy the dividends of the hard work. Because he has done so much, not just in the life of his immediate family, but in the life of everybody. When Professor Oji Oshodi steps into a function that I have been privileged to be, the kind of rousing welcome, the applause he's giving, is a clear testimony that he has impacted positively in the life of people. And this is the time for him to sit back and enjoy
the reward of the good life he has given to people. I pray that God Almighty will continue to bless him and that he will live long and celebrate many more years. Happy birthday, Professor Ojo Shudi. Wishing you long life, many happy returns.
Professor Francis Osagede, a former student of Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP and a former assistant dean and AG Dean of School of Postgraduate Studies, a former dean of student and the present dean of Faculty of Physical Sciences, is a testament to Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi's benevolence and mentorship.
My name is Osagede Francis. I was once the assistant dean of PG School and at interval, acting dean of PG School. I became the dean of students, and now I'm the dean of physical sciences. I've held so many committees. I was a member of the staff housing allocation committee for 2 terms. I also went for Senate for 2 terms before I became a life member of Senate of the great University of Benin, which I'm still a senator today. I read mass education, so he was one of my lecturers, a very great one indeed, that all the students would want to emulate him. We were proud. Many of us did not even want to go to teaching line. But because of him, that's why we are teaching today. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi is a pride of the Beninese. Oji Oshodi was born August 9th, 1950, and became a professor in 1991. Professor Ojo Oshodi is a man of few words, but his action and vigor for all he does is compared to nothing. It's of great measures. Again, his legacy as a former vice chancellor of this great University of Benin speaks volume even to date. In terms of infrastructures, creation of programs, creation of faculties and departments. And also Professor Oji Oshodi approves grants for staff to go and study abroad. Full of zeal, and above all, is a go-getter. He is a man that goes for the best, and he knows what to do at the right time. Knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. Professor Oji Oshodi knows himself. He is a wise man and just. When you are opportune to come across him, he has that confidence. If you have the confidence to talk to him, he's ready to help you to any length. He develops stride, speaks volume. That all of us will emulate his actions. And many of us also learned under his tutelage. And by the grace of God, as I've said before, his confidence is wise and is just. Just to mention but a few. And one of the potentials he has is a go-getter. He says what he means. and means what he says. Professor Ojo Shodi is a mentor to so many. And I would advise the young administrators, the young academicians, who always want to learn from him. And I will say that let us look at his own stride as a young academic. Look at what he has done and look at how you are going to do it. For the young ones, many young ones, they have pride. Remove pride and be humane. You will succeed, or they will succeed in life. Professor Oji Oshodi, let me sing this song for you. Oh, happy birthday, happy birthday, oh, happy birthday, happy birthday, oh, happy birthday.
The story of Professor Igbinadua, the present Dean of Students Affairs of the University of Benin, was not different either.
I'm Professor Patrick Usaremida Igbinadua, the Dean of Students Affairs, University of Benin. I'm a professor of pharmaceutical chemistry. Professor Oshogi has been our Vice Chancellor. He has been a former Dean of Students, former Vice Chancellor of this institution, and has been Dean of Education, and has served in virtually every committee you can talk of in this university. In the area of sports, he has been there, and there is no one who has been in this institution that has not received tremendous impact in his or her life through the life of Professor Oji Oshodi. When he was our Vice Chancellor, I was always looking for opportunity to meet with him. What endeared my heart to him was his humanitarian gesture. During his tenure as Vice Chancellor, sometimes you hear that this man will go to the bursary to go and trouble staff to make sure that fellow staff receive their salary. And I kept wondering, which kind of a Vice Chancellor have so much interest in for his staff that he can go to that extent of fighting for his staff all times? And when I became an associate professor, I had opportunities to now meet him. This was after he had left office as Vice Chancellor, before I became close to him. And what a joy to be able to the man I have learned so much, have adored and have respected. And since that incident, forever I've met him, I've read his profile and his philosophy of that humanitarian gesture have endeared me to working in that direction. And even in my faculty, I began to imbibe those same principles. And I can tell you, his life has tremendously transformed my life. If you ask my students that knew me when I was a very young lecturer, I remember I asked who was one of the most wicked lecturer in this faculty. They said, "Sir, it might not be too far from you." But since my encounter with this great man, I can tell you that they can tell you who is one of the best lecturers, they will say, "Sir, is not far from you." I think that summarizes the impact this man's life have had in my life. My association with him have changed my orientation to be more human, more humanistic, and think more of your fellow neighbor, more of those associated with you. And today I'm privileged to be Dean of Students, the very seat where my great father sat before now. And I look forward to learning more and replicating in greater dimension the footstep that O.J. Oshodi, Professor, have stepped for us. It's a big feat that he has achieved, great things that he has done, impact. When I came into this office, like I told you earlier, I started reading memos, things that he wrote, and they have tremendously formed part of my philosophy that have helped me to be able to settle down as Dean of Students. So on this occasion of his birthday, I wish him all that he will ever desire in life. I wish him the best. All that God has written in the book for him, they shall all be fulfilled. Everything that God have desired for him, for not only for him, for his children, for his grandchildren, and beyond that, these legacies which he has translated to those of us that are his children, because I consider myself as one of his children because of the things that I have benefited from him. May God continue to bless him. May God continue to lift him high. May God continue to take him to higher and higher. I wish him a long life. I wish him prosperity. And I wish you happy birthday. Happy birthday, Daddy. God bless you.
I'm Professor David Eyogbefu, former director of Servicom, and currently the director of ICT CRP. I knew Professor Oshodi when he was Dean of Students. He was a professor, I was a PhD student. And each time we met in the club, he gave me a lot of encouragement. And when he became Vice Chancellor, he appointed me as the pioneer director of Servicom from nowhere, because one, I didn't apply for the job and I didn't know how I was selected. But having been selected, he gave me all the support in the world, because the Servicom is meant to check service delivery in the university system. And knowing the culture of our people who wants to earn money without working, the unions were so much against the spirit of Servicom. But he stood by me. And even when he has left office as Vice Chancellor, each time we met, he would hold my hand and ask me, how is your office? What are the challenges? And he kept on encouraging me, directing me, and giving me ways of succeeding in that office. Since his leaving office, he should continue to show a great interest in the affairs and activities of the university. As he celebrates his 70th birthday, I wish him all the good things of life. I wish him long life, and that he shall reap the fruit of his labor.
A serious bane of academics in Nigeria today is mentorship, but this Achilles heel will be history if most of the senior academics in Nigeria today will imbibe the mentorship charisma of Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP. You have heard from pro-chancellors, chancellors, vice-chancellors, deputy vice-chancellor, universities council members, provosts and rectors, emeritus professors, deans and director, both past and present. They all agreed that Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, at 70, is living wisely and well and just. This was also the position of Professor Godspower Ekwobase, a young mentee of Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP. This foremost professor of services computing was also full of praises for Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi is a man who has lived wisely and well and just. So I can conclude that he is a man that has lived a pleasant life. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi was Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin from 2009 to 2014. And he brought so much sanity to the university, which include regular promotion and without godfatherism and employment, without you necessarily knowing anybody, irrespective of your tribe, irrespective of your religion. He employed across board during his time, and that is so what many people are rejoicing all about. Many programs were created during his time, and ever since he has remained a mentor to so many academicians, including professors and vice chancellors of many universities across the country. Professor Oji Oshodi, to me, is a man of humility. He's a listener, a strategist, a disciplinarian, a man who hates falsehood and corruption. I see him as a father who always fights for his own. I see him as a just man who is capable, is able to rebuke his own even when they are going astray. Yet, he is patient. Those are some of the attributes I have learned from Professor Oshodi. He doesn't believe in excuse. He believes in hard work. He believes in truth. He believes in excellence. Professor O.G. Oshodi has manifested so many attributes that the younger ones can learn from. The younger ones should learn to mentor people. You don't just come to this life just to succeed. We are not living to eat. Professor, the younger ones should mentor. And that is one thing he always say when he sees you as a professor. He will say, how many PhD have you produced so far? How many PhD do you have now? You have to mentor these younger ones. That is who Professor Oshodi is. His doors are open to everybody, irrespective of tribe and their religion. So we should learn also to accommodate and tolerate each other. If Professor Oji Oshodi has not taken time to master his trade, today he would have been the pride of the Benin. He would have been the great man he is today. Some people will be counting the amount or the money in the bank account or the number of houses, but to Professor Oshodi, he has invested in lives. And as Jesus Christ said it, a man should not just be judged, a man should not be judged by the abundance of the resources he has, but the amount of love, the amount of life he has impacted. Professor Oji Oshodi has impacted many lives and is still impacting lives. I want to wish him a very happy birthday. I want to wish him a happy birthday, happy 78th birthday, long life in health and prosperity. I want to pray that God should continually strengthen him and his health because of the role he's playing for University of Benin, the role he's playing for the Benins, the role he's playing for Edo State, the role he's playing for the entire Midwest and Nigeria in general. Long life and prosperity, the great one. You came and you conquered. I can say you are a great man. You have lived a pleasant life. Happy birthday, sir.
Professor Sayuki Godwin Oshodi JP is incorruptible with no criminality in his DNA. This obvious fact was further strengthened by the longest serving security personnel and the present acting chief security officer of the University of Benin, Benin City, Mrs. E.R. Osa Osifo, who could not but eulogize Professor Sayuki Godwin Oshodi JP.
I'm Mrs. E.R. Osa Osifo.
presently the acting chief security officer, University of Benin. I have been here since July 1985, precisely about 35 years now. And I've known Professor Olji Oshodin since this period, I've said. My first encounter with him was when he was a Dean of Students years back. And as a Dean of Students, as I then, he really played a fatherly role to the students here. Because as at that time, I was equally working in the Vice Chancellor's office. So we were always seeing his works and the way he was relating with our students. I remember then they would always call him Babao, Babao, and we would be laughing. Professor Olji Oshodin is a soft-spoken and gentle man that everyone would like to work with. If you ask me personally, I will say that Professor Olji Oshodin is a builder, is a welfarist. There's somebody who do not want anyone to be maligned for any reason. He prefers and wishes that what is due to you be given to you without being marginalized. Professor Oshodin has brought a lot of innovations to the university, just as we are having now with our present Vice Chancellor. So sometimes I will ask myself in this few period of our being here, is this welfare only accredited to the educationist? Because when Professor Oshodin was here as Vice Chancellor and as an educationist, we have a lot of massive buildings, massive welfare, both for staff and students. And currently, we have started enjoying the same thing with the present administration. So that is what is giving me the feelings that educationists are welfareists. Professor Oshodin is a kind-hearted man. But you may think he doesn't know what you are doing or saying, or he's not taking note of what you are passing through. But after a while, he will just call you and say, what is your problem? And before you know it, he solves it for you. And a lot more like that. As a father and as a grandfather, I will say that Professor Oshodin is the kind of man I think universities should long again for. But we are happy that, and also be consoled that we are already having his replicates. If you ask me, I will say that working with him or around him as Vice Chancellor and as a staff of this university has been a thing of joy. A lot of families has benefited from him. A lot of staff have benefited and are still benefiting from him. In fact, University of Benin history cannot be written without the name Professor Olji Oshodin. Some attributes I will take to him, which I will say personally, all that I witnessed. We lost a staff here years back. The security staff died. And when the union cried to him, he said, the only thing we'll do is not to allow the family suffer. Immediately he employed the wife. What is more than that? That is an attribute of a kind-hearted man. And I would admonish everyone that is still around to say, that these are behaviors that we should emulate. It is not only when people die and at the service of songs they will say, what will you be remembered for? You can be remembered for so many things while on earth. That is what I personally am remembering Professor Oji Oshodin for today. And so many of us and so many people has a lot to remember him for. You can say in every, at least about 70% of families on campus, they have their one attribute of Professor Oshodin to them or the other in their homes. My birthday wish for Professor Oji Oshodin, our father, great-grandfather, is that he continues to live in good health, he continues to live in joy, and continue to enjoy his children and the fruits of his labor in Jesus' name.
It should be noted that Mrs. Osa Osifo is a criminologist and has worked severally as head of the Intelligence Unit, now Surveillance and Anti-Crime Unit of the Security Department of the University of Benin, Benin City. Another dreaded security intelligence expert and present head of Surveillance and Anti-Crime Unit of the University could not also spot a dent in the person of Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP.
I'm a Dosivi Idausa. I'm a staff of the University of Benin in the Security Department. I joined the services of the University of Benin in December 2010 under the tenure of Professor Oji Oshodi as Vice Chancellor. I later became the Head of Intelligence under his tenure too. I want to say one thing or more about Professor Oshodi. Professor Oji Oshodi is a man who believes in accountability. He's a man who believes in due process. He's a man who is very compassionate. Under his tenure, more than 5,000 persons were employed. And he's a disciplinarian too. He's somebody who has zero tolerance to corruption. I remember under his tenure, a lot of persons who flouted due process. The attempts of engagement have to be sanctioned. So I would say that as a leader, Professor Oji Oshodi is a compassionate leader, very sensitive to the situations of those working under him. Under his time, we collected our hazard allowance. Salaries were paid as at 20. And if you ask me, the lessons I would learn or I've learned from him as a leader is that leaders should be compassionate. Leaders should be sensitive. Leaders should develop the habit of planning their succession. Because Professor Oshodi tried as much as he could to develop a procession plan for leadership. A procession plan. As soon as he was leaving, somebody else became a vice chancellor. And today we are building on that threshold that he has built. So I want to employ the youths who are coming up, to be loyal, to be patient, to wait for their time. Yeah, because Professor Oshodi didn't just become, when he came into university, he didn't become a professor just in one day. Through hard work, through dedication, through commitment to duty, he became what he is. And as one of those that is mentoring, I would advise that youths should be patient. They should buy their time. They should follow procedures. And they should hate corruption. Corruption does not pay. The easiest way to do things by jumping procedures is not the best way. So that's my advice. I want to use this opportunity, auspicious as it is, to wish Papa Oji Oshodi a happy birthday. I wish you a happy birthday, Daddy. God bless you.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, is still in the business of shaping the academic leaders of today. Testament to the fact that Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, JP, strongly abhors unemployment is evident as expressed by a few of those he employed during his living, particularly when he was Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin.
My name is Dr. Ebieto Mere. I am a lecturer with the Department of Computer Science. I came into the service 2011, courtesy Professor Oshodi. It is important to make clear that I am purely a Deltan, and this man gave me the very opportunity I'm standing on today. He did so for so many persons too. I first of all want to say thank you for the opportunity, sir. At this point, I want to wish him a very happy birthday, and I pray that God in his infinite mercy would sustain him the more and keep him for us. Thank you very much, sir.
My name is Andrew Imiefo Esquire. I'm the immediate past president of University Senior Staff Club. Well, Professor O.G. Oshodi, to me, is my employer. Well, Professor O.G. Oshodi, I'm one of the beneficiaries of Professor O.G. Oshodi's kind gesture to the youth when he was Vice Chancellor. A very principled man to the core, a father figure to myself and my peers, and those within my ranks, because most of us, I can say 80% of us here, was employed by Professor O.G. Oshodi. Well, going forward, you know, I learned a lot from his leadership skills. So O.G. Oshodi is a principled man, and I would like our generation to take a cue from him. He was a mentor to most of us, and I want to wish him a very happy 70th birthday. Like one of our professors here will say, after labor, rest is sweet.
My name is Isoba Fogarise Rosemary, of the Faculty of Physical Science, Department of Computer Science. This day, the person of Professor G. Oshodi gave me this job, even when he did not know me. He saw my paper and just signed, and that was how I got the job. I want to wish him a very happy birthday, long life. He will see his children's children. He will live long to reap the fruits of his labor. We all that he helped in this job wish him a very 70th happy birthday. May he live long in Jesus' name. Amen.
My name is Ifeanyi Chukwu Anyora from Department of Computer Science. And Pa Oshodi, professor of a kind. I am someone that I consider the envy of many. He became a prof at the age of 41, something very rare. And I consider him as a man who was maximally used by the institution. Because to be a prof, you are at your peak. There are positions and roles you cannot play in the institution until you become a prof. So Pa Oshodi became a prof at 41 and served the institution at maximum capacity for good 29 years. And that was why I consider God favored him and made him the VC of this school. And that position, he took a very great advantage of and empowered men. One thing I must say, I must advise many, if you want to talk ill about Pa Oshodi, don't ever try it in the land of Benin. Because if you try it, somebody you have never met, someone you have never seen, someone that you don't even know will defend him. Why? Because hardly will you come to any home in the land of Benin without seeing somebody directly or indirectly that has been affected positively by Professor Oshodi. So I want to congratulate him and I want to wish him long life as he enjoys this later part of his life. I pray that all that he has done, that God will reward him, that his labor will never be a futile one. May God bless him, give him long life and prosperity. He will live to enjoy many more years. In Jesus' name.
My name is Uigwe Terry Osarodio. I am currently the Assistant Secretary, National Association of Academic Technologies, University of Benin Branch. It may interest you to know that I got the job as a technologist in this institution during Professor Oshodi's administration. He actually gave me the job. I knew I know Professor Oshodin as a father, a principled man, and to me, he's a living legend. And I would like the youth to emulate such a man. A man that is selfless. A great contributor to the society. And on this, I would like to wish him a glorious birthday in health and long life. Thank you.
I have known Professor Oshodi right from when I was an undergraduate, when he was a dean of Faculty of Education. Professor Oshodi is somebody that I cannot really exhaust myself on what I have benefited from him. You know, Oshodi is one man that raised a lot of family in Edo State. Oshodi is one man, unknowingly to him, he solved problems, security problems. He removed young boys who were not who thought there was no hope. He took them out of the streets. They became human beings and they have raised families. And upon the fact that they raised families, they now knew that it was no longer necessary to go back to crime. So for me, Professor Oshodi is an enigma. He's a man that we must see as a role model. Professor Oshodi's benevolence is unprecedented. Unprecedented in the sense that there are certain things we actually may not go into. 2 years of Oshodi's anniversary, Oshodi gave people jobs that he never knew. The people that mention Oshodi today are people Oshodi do not even know. And as such, it is something that not just for the youth, but the leaders of this society should emulate. If Oshodi's quota to our environment and our organization, society at large, other leaders emulate that. And today, he's no longer the vice chancellor. But sorry to say, his achievement has not been surmounted. You know, and that as such, you can imagine. So for me, I pray for God to continue to bless him. Bless his family and continue to, you know, reach out to him. And of course, sorry to say, let me just quickly chip in something. There was a friend of mine when Oshodi was sick. We were talking and the guy was not having something he was doing. You know what he told me? He told me, I am praying for Oshodi to come back to office because if he comes, he will employ me. And as I speak with you today, he's a lecturer in the Department of Social Works. You can imagine. I, as a person, wish to do better than he has done. And if I cannot do better than he has done, get to the level that he got to. Because he's somebody you could reckon with.
Ejodo Modiagba is my name. I'm from the Security Department, University of Benin. When our big daddy, Elijah Professor G. Oshodi, lost his mother, the CSO recommended me to come to number 5, Omuna. That is about 8 years ago. But when I came in, people were trying to say I'm an Asian person. But daddy didn't look at that. He believed who we can deliver. And daddy took me as a son and he welcomed me. At the same time, he imparted my life as a father. Will I shock you? After the burial ceremony of the great Mama Lucy, Ifueko Oshodi, who give me grace. My wife was being employed to clerical officer in University of Benin. I never dreamed that my wife would be a staff in University of Benin. Be that as it may, after I settled down, I was also on temporary for 9 years. I entered University of Benin in 2002. We were not permanent, but it was Professor Oshodi who permitted us. And give us the notionals and give me all the promotions. In our squad, in security department, we were all permanent and confirmed. And all our entitlements was paid to us. And that is why I use all my heart to serve him as a father. Well, in this time around, I also benefited so many things from him. Attitude, he believed in truth. He said, Bible says, say the truth and the truth shall send you free. That is why he don't lie to me. Well, at this point of time, I wish him a happy birthday. on a prosperous, so many numerous years, more than 20 years. Because Bible says it's a Joseph of our time who put food in our table. May God bless our daddy and give him long life and prosperity in Jesus' name.
Students during Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP Tenor as Vice Chancellor were also full of praises for Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP at 70.
Oh, my name is Michael Onaji Tekwiriakpo. I'm an student of this institution, University of Benin. I graduated from the Department of Linguistics 2016. Professor Oshodi back then was my Vice Chancellor. Professor Oshodi was a humanitarian. He was a great man. From little we know about him from afar. During those times in school, Professor Oshodi made the University of Benin one of the leading institutions in the country. Again, we also know that in his days as the Vice Chancellor of this great institution, he made the institution a place where many young persons that should be employed, you know, employed, and he employed them.
The man, Professor Osayuki Oshodi, is an institution with different faculties and departments. He is an elder statesman. He is an erudite scholar, a man who has impacted lives positively, both in the academic world and in the world at large. He's a man who believes the sky is wide enough to contain everybody. The man who believes in the well-being of people. I want to thank God for his life because God has made him to be a man who is answered to people's questions and solution to problems. Above all, he's a man that is not destabilized. In regards of your religion, your ethnic groups, your tribe, or wherever you come from, is a man who has blessed, who has touched life positively. You see, life is not about in acquisition, but life is impartation. Has imparted life positively. A man who believes that live and let's live. A man who has done so well, who has made the Benin Kingdom proud. He has brought so much glory, honor, and pride to the Benin Kingdom. He has brought this state map to the world map. It's a man I respect so much. I want to thank God for his life. You see, because you see, the Bible said with long life, that satisfies you. He's alive today, not because he wants to be alive, but God is answering people's prayers who he has blessed. I wish him a very merry, happy birthday. Above all, you see, he's 70 years today. In my own calendar, it's a new dawn of his life. He's going to see many more things ahead. Because he has done so well, he has done so good. I pray God give him long life, give him good health, so as to continually help humanity. He has done what Napoleon could not do. He has blessed life. He has given jobs, employment to people who today they are happy, thereby making the economy of this nation to boom.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP was not just an academic and administrator of no mean repute, but he also enjoyed his living and had time for recreational activities. Here is what some of his friends and members at Benin Club has to say.
My name is Sam Moses Aroko, a friend over many decades of Professor Osayuki Oshodi. Osayuki Oshodi, a great friend, a dependable friend, a wonderful administrator, is somebody that I've assisted with over a long time. And during the period, I've known him to be quite reliable and dependable. During the period of his stay, which has continued to be in the University of Benin, he has done wonderfully well. At different times, dean of one place or the other, director here and there, he's done greatly well. And as Vice Chancellor, we are all very proud of him. He brought glory to the university and brought glory to the land. In fact, many of us are expecting that he will still be available to render service to this state, to this country, and to humanity. I congratulate him on his 70th birthday. It's a thing of joy to us that he's celebrating on his 70th birthday. We join him and wish him the very best and pray that this will not be the beginning of greater things to happen in his life. To God be the glory.
I'm Dr. Ewazegbe Esibo, a staff of the University of Benin, lecturer, banking and finance departments,
Faculty of Managerial Science. Professor Shode, how would I describe him? In so many words, but let me just use the words that will be appropriate. He's a father, he's a mentor to many of us. In fact, there's no words to describe him. He has been a helper, he has been a great provider. He has put smiles in so many people's face in the world. And that is why today we want to say thank you to him. We want to say a job well done. Because he has changed the narrative in the Benin when they say Giao, meaning it's not possible. He is the Benin man I know that has changed that narrative and said, oh, Giao, which means it is possible. And we know what he did. His legacy investor of Benin is unpredictable, and nobody will ever say he has not done well. And we want to wish him the best of life. And we want to wish him that God will continue to extend his life. As many as those that he put smiles in their face, that is the number of years God will allow him to live in this life. Because we want generations to come to see what he has done, to see his legacy in this world. And that's why we are doing this today. And we want to say, Daddy, happy birthday, and may God bless you and going to protect you in everything you do in your life. Thank you, Daddy, and God bless you.
Our Daddy, Professor Sayuki Shode, is a very highly respected member of the new club and one of the elders, and indeed the patron of the billiard and snooker section of the club. He has been a member for several years in good standing, and he has contributed immensely to the growth and development of Benin Club. In fact, we recently started some massive renovation of the swimming pool section in the club while he was the Vice Chancellor of the University of Benin. And through his input, the university has given us immense support towards that project. And we have someone to thank him for. As he celebrates his 70th birthday, which is 3 score and 10 years, we want to congratulate him and celebrate with him and wish him many, many happy and healthy years ahead. I know he still has a lot to contribute to society, both to the club and society at large. And I congratulate him and his family as active members of Benin Club. I'm speaking in my capacity as the Honorable Secretary of this club, Benin Club.
Can you just describe Professor Oshodi, his attributes, what you know about him, that will make some of our youth to be a better person in the future?
Professor Sayuki Oshodi is indeed a model to most of us, young, up and coming professionals and academicians. I know some of my friends that have been groomed by him in the academia, and he has been a good role model. Even when he was Dean of Student Affairs at Uniben, I didn't go to Uniben, but I heard a lot of good things about him there, and up to when he became Vice Chancellor, and throughout his tenure, he made impact as Vice Chancellor to ensure that the youth of this community of Benin were empowered through employment in different parts of the university. And a lot of my friends owe him that gratitude. And even here in the club, he helped a lot of our members' children in terms of employment. Qualified persons that were given chance to be employed carefully at the university, all thanks to Professor Oshodi.
A little wonder when Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP was poisoned by the enemy. He did not die, and he's alive today, strong and healthy, to celebrate his 70 years birthday anniversary. And as Professor Ekwobase prophesied in the 232nd inaugural lecture of the University of Benin, that all those that wish Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP death, Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP will attend their burial.
And not only is it happening because he's a child, the way he's running the affairs of the university, but because of the way he's taking care of the John Wayne Wan Greenberg of the University of Benin. And all those that wish the John Wayne Wan Greenberg for the question to death is going to attend all of them their burial ceremony.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP is also a happy and fulfilled family man, as attested to by his wife and children. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP is married to Mrs. Otasowie A. Oshodi, the immediate past registrar of University of Benin and an astute administrator for 39 years now. They are blessed with 5 biological sons. Mrs. Oshodi prayed God to continually keep Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP in good health and wished the love of her life a happy birthday.
I am Mrs. Otasowie Adefunke Oshodi, the daughter of late Chief M.I. Agmontine, the Eweka Gosa Doba of Benin, and Mrs. Adiola Agmontine. I got married to my husband, Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi, in May 1981. We have 5 sons. They are Dr. Osabunye Esosa Oshodi, Uwaifi Okun Abiodun Oshodi, Osarume Osareti Oshodi, Dr. Osewonyemi Ikmomosa Oshodi, and Uyosa Oshodi. We both started work in the University of Benin in 1981. He rose through his career as an academic and became a professor and later vice chancellor of the University of Benin. I also rose through my career in the administrative cadre and later became registrar from 2015 to 2020 in the University of Benin. We've been married for almost 40 years, and he's been a good father and grandfather to his children and grandchildren. And it's been good being married to him this 39 years. God has been with us, and God has seen us through these years. And I pray that God, who has kept him up to this age of 70, will prolong his life so that he will live long to see he's seen some of his children's children, his grandchildren. We have 5 grandchildren. We still hope that the other remaining sons will get married to godly wives and they have grandchildren. He will see his children's children in the name of Jesus. So I wish him well, and I also wish my children well and my grandchildren. So I wish him a happy 70th birthday.
The children of Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP, both at home and in diaspora, describe their father as a sincere, hardworking, intelligent, and a disciplinarian whose life has touched theirs in different ways. The children, grandchildren, in-laws wish Baba the best as he marks his birthday today, August 9th.
I'm so happy and joyous today. I'm celebrating my father's birthday. My father is a very great man. He has done a whole lot for a whole lot of people in this life. I say a very big happy birthday, a very great happy birthday to my father, Professor O.G. Oshodi, the greatest man that I know.
My name is Wee Oshodi. I'm the last son of Professor O.G. Oshodi and Mrs. Oye Oshodi. I just want to wish my dad a happy 70th birthday. My dad has been a great man to all of us all, his children, and a great husband to my mom. He has been a great man in the society, and I just want to wish him a happy 70th birthday. We love him from his children.
Happy birthday, Grandpa. We love you. Happy birthday, Grandpa. We love you. Happy birthday, Grandpa. We love you.
Happy birthday, Daddy. Wish you long life and prosperity. You will live to see your children's children's children in Jesus' name.
Happy birthday, Dad.
You're the best dad in the whole wide world. I wish you more life and strength in your life in Jesus' name. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Grandpa. Happy birthday to you.
Hip hip
hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip hip.
Hooray.
Happy birthday, Dad. I wish you more years. Thank you for all the lessons. I really appreciate catching up with you. Looking forward to your birthday while we celebrate it via Zoom. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you, sir. More years of blessings and prosperity. Thanks for everything. You've been amazing to us. Thank you so much. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Hello, Daddy. Wish you a happy birthday. I want to thank you so much for so many years of support and guidance. Wish you long life and great health. Wish you many more grandchildren. Happy birthday. God bless.
I am Mr. Owafioko Oshodi. I'm the second son of Professor Oji Oshodi. I want to wish him a happy birthday. Happy 70th birthday. I want to thank God for your life. You've been a great blessing to me. And I pray for more blessings for you and long life for you.
The academic icon, Professor Sayuki Godwin Oshodi JP, a certified teacher with the Teachers Registration Council of Nigeria, started his career as a college assistant in the Department of Academic Skills SIC program at the Hunter College City University of New York in 1972 and rose through the ranks till the 15th day of March 1991 when he became a professor of health education in the University of Benin. After many years of dedicated service to the university, service in various capacities, he became the vice chancellor on 1st December 2009. Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP unveiled his secret of success as vice chancellor of the University of Benin, academician, administrator, mentor, and fulfilled family man.
I grew up in the system. That was one major advantage I had. And I knew everything that was going on. And I often have wondered, why is this like this? Why is this like that? Why is this impossible? So when I took over, I decided to address some of these issues. I took up with the issue of promotion. Like you said, it was a misery. Even I was oppressed. And I was wondering why I was oppressed. But I did not want others to be oppressed. What I inherited was that, take the professorial promotion. Some people were being told they were being assessed. They were never assessed. Their papers were thrown out, put in toilets and stores. I brought some of those ones out, sent them away, and followed it up. I don't send people's papers away and relax. Say, let the man write it at the time. I give the time limits. And when I don't hear from you, I start pressurizing you. Through phones, through more letters, reminders. They responded. If you say somebody is already qualified as a professor, why would you want to delay it? Some people spent 3 years. I'm one of those who spent 3 years waiting. And I said, if the person is already found promotable, why should he wait for 3 years? I also observed that sometimes the papers come, they are never read. I'm going to say this today. I know of a professor or some group of professors who came to me, two or three of them. They said, oh, you send their papers away, the papers come, you just read it immediately. It's not supposed to be done like that. I said, where is the guideline that said that when the papers come, you keep it? He said, I should read it systematically. Say, which, what is systematical? So these are some of the tactics they were using to oppress all of us. So that is with promotion. Not only for professorship, other, even non-academic staff, we have been oppressed. And there were departments that didn't have professors because there is one professor there and he wants to be the only professor there for life. There were departments like that, the people never observed it. So I broke into it. For infrastructure, let me today thank the federal government and their fund. They helped me a great deal in funding of those infrastructures. Presented my papers, they got them approved, and they funded it. Talking of infrastructure, I didn't depend on their fund alone. I generated my own funding. That is why every time people say there is no money, I begin to wonder. That water factory, everything I did in Ekawa campus, I generated all the money from water factory and use it for a K1 campus, to develop a K1 campus. The gate is also generating money. In fact, these two places are generating millions of naira. So I discovered with the gate, they were just embezzling it. Because when the committee I met on the ground, I asked them, I said, okay, how much do you make in a year? He said, 390,000, something like that. I said, in a year? And I passed through that gate every day. I said, it can't be. With all these vehicles. So, I decided to disband that committee and look for. There are a lot of dedicated people in the community. I picked three people. Oh, they said, no, it's not done like that. Those committees should continue and serve their time as a town. I said, I'm starting a new town, so I should start with new people too. So, these people went to work. First week, they came up with about 900,000. Mm-hmm. I said, I have to ask them to repeat it. I said, how much did you say that 900,000? I said, okay. Following week, it was 1.something million. I said, these people are going to stay. I met resistance, so, because I inherited some principal officers who were used to the game. They fought me hands down and said no way. That the committee I met on the ground must continue. I said, no, they cannot continue because this is a new government. That is how I used a lot of the IGRO for those structures you are seeing there. Very many of them. If you look at my handing over notes, I don't have a copy here now. I wish I can get have them in my office. I've given you one, but I circulated it to all senators when I was going away. You will see the details there. I also looked at the academic programs. I discovered that in the whole of South-South zone, there are programs that are not in existence in any of the universities. So what I now did, I listed those programs on my own. Looked at people's CVs. For example, we didn't have veterinary medicine. Just want to use that as an example. And I discovered that somebody was in pharmacy that read veterinary medicine. So I called him, said, can't you write a proposal on veterinary medicine? He said he can't. So he wrote one. So I processed them. In fact, I doubled almost all the programs that I met on the ground. Many in engineering. I processed them and got them all approved. To date, the first veterinary medicine school in any university in South-South is only University of Benin. Estate management, the same thing. They are all listed in the handing over note. Very many of them. I developed those programs. I also said, okay, there are people that are just with a master's degree. They were stuck. They couldn't go further. So I invited some of them. What is the problem? Some said funding. I went to Tefon, got funding, started sending them away for their PhD or even masters. And I was very happy that many of them, even before I left office, have graduated from all these programs. Some are even professors today. I also looked at welfare of staff. As of that time, they were not getting salary in time. So this salary matters a lot. When you get it in time, you are able to plan. So I ensure, Boston people can testify to that. When I'm coming from home, I used to visit Boston. What's happening today? So everybody have to sit up. So we were able to pay very early. That's why I end the name Shodi Shalat.
Shodi Alat.
So I also look at arrears never paid. I paid all the arrears before I left there. Who will be owed money for close to 10 years, they won't pay. I paid them off. And I gave the staff whatever is due to them. So the students, so whatever is due to the students, I also gave them. I had a working work study program where I was also paid student from the IGRO, sending them to come and work within the university, all sorts of jobs related to the courses they were studying. I also did that.
The academic Don have his words on how he view human beings, the reason it is godly to encourage everyone to attain higher levels academically.
In life, human management is very important. No human being is useless. That is my principle. Not a single human being, whether he's a cleaner, I have to tell people, the cleaner cleaning your office is as important as a professor, as the bosser. So I don't underrate anybody. The first driver that drove me in university of Benin, I encourage him so much, he's pursuing a PhD today in England. Driver. And I was always talking to him. Can't you go to school? He said, he didn't have money. I said, okay. We organized for you. Didn't have school cert. I gave him money, went and did school cert. Passed. That's how we started. Now the jam. Say no money for jam. I gave him money. Pass. He entered university. Got first degree. Got second degree. Today, he's pursuing a PhD in driver. So, don't ever underrate any human being. I don't.
Professor Osayuki Godwin Oshodi JP says hard work and consistency is the key to greatness.
Younger generation, hard work. I've not told you how I climbed up. When I got to Juniper, like I said earlier, promotion was like going to look for golden fish in an ocean. So and I discovered, what is the mystery behind this? And I advised myself, if I publish, can this stop me from being promoted? Luckily, I went to an Ivy League university in the US. Don't know whether you know what I mean by Ivy League. It's a renowned university. There, you are taught hard work. You are taught how to publish. So I started having sleepless nights, reading and publishing. So when it was time for promotion, when I submit my papers, the assessors will be saying, this one would have been kept for the next promotion or not this promotion. I was telling them, keep it. At the next promotion, I will do more than this. So hard work is the answer. Nothing else. There is no mystery about promotion, publication. Once you are in academy, it's either you public or you perish. For non-academics, it's also hard work too. Those who have worked very hard for the system and that have been consistent, not running up and down like politicians from APC today, tomorrow is PDP. No, some of our people run from one university to another. So the best thing, you stay in one. I stayed in the University of Benin. I published there and climbed up as of 20.
Happy birthday to an academic icon, Professor Godwin Osayuki Oshodi, JP. Indeed, you came, you saw, you conquered. Indeed, you've had a pleasant living. God bless your new age with good health, long life, and sound mind.